accomplishments of our kids here, student athletes. We're not going to lose sight of that, okay? But it would be remiss of me if I didn't acknowledge that there was also some sadness on the part of a lot of us, and really the entire high school faculty, as well as our student body, I believe. Coach Lueckes no longer be coaching or teaching here at New Haven. Sorry about this, but I've dealt with Coach for many, many years and at just about nearly every level. When I came here 30-some years ago, he was at South Corn High School, and he was a member of my very first junior varsity basketball team. He was my starting outfielder for first three varsity baseball squads. He is a good player, okay, but he is even a better person, better teammate. He is coachable at that time. He was a hardworking kid. He carried a positive attitude, and he was always unselfish. He always put the team ahead of himself. Little did I know that when he walked out of here as a graduate, that just a few short years later, he'd be returning as a colleague when he was hired as an industrial arts teacher. Over the past 21 years, he's served our athletic department in numerous capacities. He's been a junior high basketball coach, assistant track coach, assistant girls basketball coach, and now for the past 5 years, our varsity girls basketball coach. During this time, those same character traits that he displayed and developed 30 years ago as a student athlete have been displayed on a daily basis. Mr. Lueckes's been a hardworking, dedicated teacher and coach. He's maintained that same team-first, positive attitude. He's maintained high expectations for the students he works with, the kids he coaches. Most importantly, he's been a positive role model and had a positive impact on countless young people. Over the past 4 years now, I've seen Coach through a different set of eyes. I've seen him through the eyes of a parent. What I've seen is a coach that will go above and beyond what he's contracted to do. Okay? He'll go above and beyond for the good of my daughter, for the good of her teammates, for the good of the girls' basketball program. Okay? A coach does not have to give up their time and make the effort to conduct open gyms, conduct summer camps, take their teams to those camps, leagues, shootouts, etc. Set up preseason conditioning and weightlifting programs, because if you do that, then you got to be there to supervise. Coach does not have to organize elementary school level teams to give kids a chance to get going in fourth, fifth, sixth grade level. Because doing so means you got to order the uniform, you got to set up the schedule, you got to find the coaches. A coach does not have to conduct tournaments, youth tournaments, to give those kids a chance and an opportunity to play here in New Haven. All that entails is starting months in advance to find teams to come to your tournament, organize your tournament, find volunteers to officiate, volunteers to keep the scorebook, run the clock, run the gate, etc. Nor is a coach obligated to come to spend his free winter nights, when he gets them, to go scout opponents with the hope of finding that thing or two that might just give your team an edge. Coach Lueckes did all of these things and more. Okay? Although it may be thought by some that all coaches everywhere do all these things, they don't. When you find one who does, you can consider yourself lucky, and we've been lucky. As a parent, all I wanted was my daughter and her teammates to have the opportunities to improve and be successful. I wanted her to be pushed to be better, because it's human nature, she wasn't going to push herself. I expected the coaching to be hard, tough, to the point, demanding. If she gave less than her best effort, didn't accept the coaching, copped an attitude, or continually repeated mistakes. Coach Lueckes's done all these things. And so as a parent, and I think I can speak for my wife as well, we're grateful, extremely grateful. So again, You know, I've observed Coach Leakey on a daily basis through many different perspectives over the years, come away with nothing but admiration and respect every step of the way. I'm also confident in saying that every coach on his staff, as well as our entire faculty, has that same admiration, respect, and appreciation for what he's done. On behalf of all of your fellow coaches up here, as well as others here tonight, we're going to miss you. We wish you nothing but the best. We thank you for all you've done, and we hope you'll forever be a Shamrock at heart. Thank you, Coach.